Hey, what's up, gardening friends? Jeff here at Tropical Plant Party. How's everybody doing? Hope you're good. I'm great. I am in a rush. It's just, you know, I just finished with the vlog that came out this past weekend. And then all of a sudden I get a phone call from the people who store my, these are champagne problems, so take any complaining with a grain of salt. But the palm tree people called and said, hey, we're gonna be there tomorrow to take your palm trees. So I was like, okay, well, that's good. Not much notice. And then I have a tree trimming company that's supposed to be handling this big pine here. They were supposed to come out in November. They just showed up and they're like, yeah, well, we're gonna do that now. And they're gonna trim up my oak. It's hard to tell. There's a lot of, and now we have airplanes, very loud airplanes. I don't have time to wait for the planes to pass. This big pin oak here has a whole bunch of dead stuff, and I don't know how you're gonna be able to see it. Yeah, you can see that better. There's a bunch of dead limbs in there, lots of dead tips and ends on the tree. Don't know what it's about. An arborist looked at it. It has gull wasps. Yeah, I don't know how you'll be able to see it, but that might have something to do with it. The thing I was surprised about, though, is with the pine tree over here, I have all these plants in the way, and he said that he can get it out without me having to move the plants. I don't know how that's possible, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Oh, the one next to it's kind of starting to yellow also. Oh, so's that one. I don't think that's pine decline. Sometimes they just get some yellowy needles and start dropping them in the fall time. I'm interested to see how they get that out of there without me having to move my plants. That's why I'd ask them to wait till November, because there's the, you know, the plants everywhere, but they said they can do it. Whenever they're done with that, I'm going to go around to the palm trees that go out for winter storage and pull any plants that I want to make sure that they won't die. Because the people who take the palm trees for the winter, they only guarantee the palm trees. They take all the stuff out that's planted around them. So I need to lift the caladiums. I might pull the I potted up one dragon's wing begonia just kind of for jits and shiggles. I don't need more than that. Like, you can take cuttings of those so easily. I have some heliconias to lift from the adonidia. And another airplane. This is going to be a fun vlog. It's over here. I've just been standing here doing some dishes. And then I look up and there's people in my trees. Hoping that maybe you'd be able to see those dead limbs a little bit better, but eh. Not really. I had to really rush around out there because they were getting ready to set up. I don't like filming around people. It weirds me out. You can kind of see those brown tips a little bit better from here. Not really. Maybe I can drop my expo. That didn't help at all. Anyways, what I was getting at while I was outside was I have a lot to do and very little time to do it because the tree trimming is pretty noisy. So I'll wait till they're gone, I guess. We will see. I don't know if you'll remember this, but when that pine tree started to die and I was like, eh, it's not the end of the world. I won't even notice it being gone. I've been out here 5 minutes and I was like, oh yeah, there used to be a pine tree there. Yeah, there's a gap, but it's a gap that's going to let in more light. And the trees here, the spruce and the pine, they're growing, so that's whatever. Wow, now that looks better. You just have to take my word for it. There wasn't able to get you a good shot of the tree before, but yeah, it had some little dead tips going all the way up there, and I mean, they probably cleared a good 6 feet of trunk of just lower limbs. That's nice. Nice and open. It's good to take care of the oaks. They live a long time. Okay, now I need to get those palm trees ready, and I have to do it quickly because I also hadn't mentioned this. I have family coming in town tonight, which I'm really excited about. They're only going to be here for a few days, but you know, they did the whole thing, getting COVID tested and then quarantining for a couple weeks. I'm excited to see them. It's not as easy to get together anymore, as I'm sure everybody else is very aware of. So I don't know how much of a priority gardening is going to be this week, at least not for the next few days. I guess I need to move all of the things so they can get the Robolini palm out of here. Why are you thirsty? Is the timer broken? Timer on the, whatchamacallit thingy, the drip system? It did get very, very warm today, so I don't know. It'll be easier for them to move the plant if it's a little bit more dry. I want to make sure that I don't lose track of where the bulbs are. Usually I can just lift these out, but sometimes they root in really, really heavily. Yeah, that came out just fine. I would prefer to use a spade, but it's okay. This works too. Let those sit in there for now, and I'll start gathering the rest of the things. Right over here, the heliconia, which has some cold damage on it, but that's not really that big of a deal. Oh, this did a lot of growing. I don't know how all that's going to come up, though. Okay, all right. Should come up reasonably well. Yep, got the whole clump there. And I have another caladium back here that is hiding. You guys can't see any of this. It's already started to kind of die back, so I don't know if I'll be able to lift this or not. There we go. Nah, that came up. That's good. I was thinking that it might be a little bit too loose from the bulbs to come up, but it's all good. Oh, there's another. I have to get another one of those. One of those, you know what I mean? The, what's it called? The frog in a blender. Normally, I go through and I remove all of the annuals from the planters before they get taken away. All right, so see, that didn't work. So now I need to go find my spade. Didn't find the spade, but I have fingers. I don't mind getting a little dirty. Put that in here so I don't forget. These are both the frog and the blender. This one, I think it's called Super White, Moon White, something like that. Don't know, I always forget. Anyways, what I was saying is normally when the palm trees are getting picked up, I go through and clear out all the annuals and I pull all of the palm trees out and put them together so that they can just take them. Can't really move these this year. That's too much, you know. Still have the surgery stuff that I'm healing from. So I'm just going to have to be okay with the fact that I am paying somebody to come out here and move these and to just let them do their jobs. I just don't like other people doing things for me, but it's okay. That's the whole point here of the service of the people coming to take the plants. They can just do it themselves. That's fine. I don't think I have anything planted underneath the other palm trees that are being taken. They're going to take that Robolini palm over there, which I just gave a heavy prune to. That'll be in a video at some point. They're going to take the Alexander palm because obviously that's not fitting in the house. It hasn't fit in the house in years. The adonidia with the two trunks looked like this. We were just down there. I was just talking about it. I was talking about the plants that are under it. Anyways, I called them and said that they need to bring a crane. I really hope that they do, because I said that because I don't want to have to move and dig up everything for them to get this plant out of here. If they bring the crane, I know how ridiculous this sounds. This is just the things we do for what we love. Then they can just lift it out, and then they won't have to move out. I hope they listened. They tend to not sometimes, though, so we'll have to wait and see what happens tomorrow. I don't know if I'll be able to vlog it or not. It kind of depends on when they show up. Then I'm going to have them take one of the big queen palms. I might have them take both of them because they don't fit in the house anymore. And then I'm not ready to tear this up, like just emotionally and physically. Like, I don't think I even should be doing that with my body right now. But this queen palm grew so much that I don't think it's going to fit in my house. It doesn't seem likely. I mean, there's a frond here. And then all the way over here, there's another one right back there. The spread on this thing is massive. It grew so much. Really, so did that one. I don't know. I'll figure all that out. We'll pick up with some repots and some other things later. Hey, Tobes. How you doing, Toby? You such a good boy, Toby. Got both my doggies out here. Hey, Tuck. Yeah, nice to see you too, Tucker. Holy flippin' busy week. It's like, I want to say about 4 days from the last clip, they came and got the palm trees, picked them up. It was starting to drizzle, so it was kind of like a mad dash to get the palm trees out. I had to make some last minute decisions. Like, I decided to send some of the queen palms to the greenhouse because they grew so much this year that I was like, there's no way. I don't want to even try and mess with getting these in the house or dealing with them. So they're off into storage. Now I'm sitting out here looking at my blank spaces and really not that bothered by them. I mean, it's a mess, but this is nothing compared to what it's going to look like out here 3 weeks from now. Had a lovely time with my family in town visiting, had some appointments and filmed a video and got that out in place of the video that was supposed to be out. That's a whole big long thing. I had a video that was going to be out about the Robolini palms, but the lighting the day that I filmed it, I only had one day to film that video because I found out they were coming a week earlier than I thought they were to get those palm trees, so I had to last minute get that filmed, and the lighting was just awful. There's something in the sky, I don't know what it was, it's like the air, the angle of the clouds, something. It was just, the video's not going to be pretty. I've been doing some color correcting, but it's going to take some time to even try and get it presentable and at its best. It's probably still not going to look that great, but it's okay. At least I got it done. So now I just need to handle all those caladiums that I pulled up and those heliconias. And then the weather forecast just changed and it's going to get down to 33 degrees tonight. So I get to move the plants inside again. Yay! Nah, that's to be expected this time of year. It's fairly simple. I've done it, what, 2 vlogs in a row? I load them up, take them in. Not a big deal. Not going to bore y'all with that again. But as far as these caladiums are concerned, I do need to get these cut up and ready to get put away. These right here, those big white ones that I pulled out, I think they're called, like, Moonlight, Moonshine, or maybe White Christmas? I can't remember.
Yeah, big white leaves. That's what I know about them.
I need to set those aside so they don't get mixed up with the frog and a blender caladiums.
Remember these ones I pulled out from underneath that Roblini palm? My favorite caladiums. I am sad. I really enjoy looking at these, but they'll be back next year. Normally, with my caladiums, I've done this in videos before. I pull them up, cut the foliage off, clean all the soil out from around the little bulbs, and put them in a box with some perlite and keep them someplace dark and cool, like in a box.
I am fresh out of perlite, so I'm going back to my old ways, which is a little bit more risky, but it works. It's the way people have been doing things for many, many, many years. It'll be okay. I'm still going to loosen the soil, but these are nice and dry, so I'm just going to store them away just as they are, like this, in a box.
I panicked. A little while ago, I was searching my house. I was like, oh no, I don't have a box. And I realized there was a box on my front porch because Pam from Pammy's Planty thinks, where is it? She sent me this little turtle, and it's cute, and that's just the cutest little thing. So that was a good timing. One, Pam, thank you. This is adorable. And I have a box to put the caladiums in. I'm going to add this to my pots. I'm going to drill holes. I'm going to try and drill a tiny little hole in there.
Oh, boom. There. That'll work for that clump. Almost forgot I have another clump of these. I suppose I could try and get some more out of these if I really, really wanted to, but since the soil is so dry, I don't think it's necessary. As long as this doesn't get wet while it's being stored, it should be fine. One of the main reasons to get the soil out is you help eliminate any risk of pests like root mites and different things like that that could chew away at the plants. There have been plenty of times where I took caladiums and just cut the foliage off and stored them away with their pots and everything, and then just brought them out and started watering them again this spring, and they were okay. And I can't even put this away just yet anyways. I want these to dry out a little bit more. So this is just going to go inside and hang out on my counter or someplace dark for a few more days, so those have died back a little bit more. And the other thing too is with the caladiums, I'm gonna try and get them started earlier this year. Typically I've been waiting until it's time to bring the plants outside. This year I'd like to get them going sooner than that. After they've had 12 weeks to rest, 16 at the most, I'll go ahead and pot them up and get them going again inside, because they're so fun to look at. I don't want to have to spend any more time away from those pretty caladiums than I have to. I've gone ahead and I put those super white caladiums in a paper bag with some holes punched in it. Then you just fold that down, staple it shut, make sure to label it. It'll be fine as long as it stays dry and dark for the winter time. When you're in the middle of a sentence and you forget everything you're saying. That's why things like trail off and don't make sense by the time I'm done talking sometimes. Over here is another one of these super white, or like I said, maybe it was super Christmas. I don't remember. Big white caladiums. This is one that I really just forgot to plant. It never got planted. Well, I didn't really forget. I knew that it needed to be planted, but you know what was going on this year. So I have an option here. I could go ahead, pull these up, cut them back, do everything you just saw, or I got dirt in my turtle. Well, I guess that's okay, because this is meant to have soil in it. Or I could treat this kind of like I do with a lot of my curcumas, which is, well, that doesn't really, it's not a great equation, because sometimes I dig my curcumas up, or sometimes I'll just let them die back on their own and just store them pot and all, soil and everything, just keep them dark and dry. The advantage to just letting them do their own dieback is all that nutrient, like I talked about with the colocasias last week, all those nutrients can get back down there into the bulb and you have a stronger bulb. So it's good to allow them to do it themselves. Whereas if you cut it off, you've stopped that process from happening. That's going to be the case with the caladiums that I pulled up. But where I live, usually the cold and the frost comes before the caladiums know that it's time to die back. This is one of the first times I've had one that started to do its own dieback on its own, because usually that happens like November-ish, and by November these things are toast outside where I am. Since I already have a box with the box you just saw, that's sitting in my house on my counter right now in the dark, I think I'm just going to take this and let it sit right next to it and let it do its own dieback and leave it alone. I'll still more than likely lift them, get some of the soil out, and put them in a bag with the others. My concern is more that I'll misplace them, like I'll get them mixed up or something if I don't keep them together, but that's probably just what I'm going to do with these. Just gonna let them do their own thing. And all of that brings me to these. You remember these? They look familiar? Probably not. I didn't really circle back to them very much after I planted them, because they didn't
They didn't do anything. These were the alocasia helo beauties. Alocasia, colocasia. Actually, the more reading I do on these is suggesting that these might even actually be more of a caladium than any of those other things. Which it doesn't really matter because this is what they did. While adorable and cute, it's a disappointment. I was hoping for great big beautiful plants. Not what happened here. There's some kind of differentiation, some sort of splitting. Something happened with those bulbs that made them go, ooh, we're gonna put up little babies instead of just big plants. So with these, I don't know. I was kind of entered into this like I had a plan. I don't necessarily have a plan. I could do any of the things like I just talked about with the caladiums. I don't know, but what I do know is that 33 is going to be too cold for these, so they're going inside. Okay, and last up, the heliconias. They look fantastic, don't they? No, not so much. All that growth up there may end up dying off. I don't know for sure. I've gone ahead and just potted them up in these pots that are extremely shallow, probably a smidge too small for them. But my main concern right now is just rehydrating the plants, not so much getting them to grow and grow and grow. And heliconias are so incredibly prone to rot during the winter time when you have them inside, which is why it's also usually a good idea to try and treat those rhizomes with a fungicide, and then making sure that they're in a soil that's going to drain very well and not stay wet for too terribly long. That's going to help with that also. But again, I don't have super high hopes for these. I just want to make sure that I can keep their root system alive. All this up here, that may end up just dying, because it already is. They were just ripped right out of the pot that they were in, and they already had some cold damage on them. The problem with most heliconias is that you can't just dig the rhizomes up and cool store them. They don't really do well with that. They don't handle a dormancy, at least not for a very long time. So keeping them indoors can be a little bit tricky because they like things really warm and humid. Even in my grow space, I usually struggle with heliconias, but I had these on my shelves for a couple of months last winter and they actually did really, really well. So I'm going to give them a chance, but I don't have high hopes. Okay, those are done. There's still many, many, many more of those things to do, but y'all don't need to see it. It's going to be the same thing you just watched. Now, the sad part, something I really haven't wanted to do, but needs to be done. Like, really needs to be done. They don't even look that good anymore. Time to go ahead and cut all the annuals out from underneath these palm trees. We had a good run. It was a beautiful year. What's nice though is at least it's easy work. Most of these just pull right up. Yeah, I do try and get as many of the roots as I can, just so that those aren't rotting and decaying in the house during the winter time. Things aren't as warm, and it opens up a gap to put some fresh soil in the pots. That's always nice. Now that's pretty sad looking compared to with the flowers, but it's okay. Now the palm trees can shine and have their moment. These were by far my favorite planters I've ever done out here. It was just so, well, I don't know about my favorite ever. These were by far my favorite of anything I've done with the pool pots around the pool. There was just so much color. It was beautiful. The cordylins, the fruticasas, there's a cordylin fruticasa kiwi, those colorful guys right there. I went ahead and I pulled them. I'm on the fence about overwintering them inside just because the mealybugs love those cordylins so much that I just don't know if I want them around the plants that are actually going to be in the house as opposed to in the grow space. It's a lot harder to deal with bugs on the plants when they're in the house, as I know you all know, especially the bigger ones where I can't just take it off to a shower or sink and spray it down and hose it off that way. I will probably dry store them, which I learned over the summer as an option. Hadn't known that before, but I had a few of them that didn't make it outside this year and they just survived. Don't know how. Didn't water them, but it stayed dark and they just defoliated, and then they got a splash of water a few weeks ago and just poof. So that was several months of just being dry and dark. I thought they were just going to die. So I'll probably go ahead and give that a shot with these just because it's one less thing to have to worry about. Need to get them cleaned up and sprayed down though. These palm trees do look a lot bigger without all those plants in the pots though, don't they? It's not a drastic difference, but they do look bigger. Look at the big pile of stuff that came out of those. So much. And that was the only thing that I didn't like about having these potted up so heavily, is one of the things I enjoy about the adonidia palms and just palms in general that have this characteristic. I really like the swollen bases, the little
bulbous bases that they get, and you can't really see that when these are planted up very heavily. That's a sacrifice I was willing to make for all that fun color, that rainbow of flowers that was going around the bottom of the pots. It's still nice to be able to get in and actually see the plants in their full glory.
Well, here we are again, just like last week.
I went ahead and decided to take the adonidia palms and lay them down. You can see it. Do I even need to explain what happened here?
I'll be safer down close to the ground where there's some warmth. The warmth will still radiate up there and take care of those, just because I don't have the space yet to move these in, or really the capability.
Laying them down on their side wasn't too difficult to do, but I'm still kind of like, I'm not quite sure I should have done it, but I was working with gravity instead of against it, so it worked out okay.
Only reason I did this was because the forecast throughout the day keeps changing from like 36 to 32, and then it went up to 34, now it's down to 33.
I have no idea what's going to happen, but I don't like the adonidias to go below 35. I would prefer them to stay above 40, but that's below 35, there will be damage.
Should be okay, they're tucked in for the night.
Everything else that I can get inside is inside. I'll drop some frost cloths over some things, and that might be about it. Yeah, I came back out here and I looked at these heliconias, and I was like, what, why? Not entirely sure why I bothered with this. These are what dead and dying heliconias look like. I'll give them a cut back and water them and see what happens, but they're not valuable enough to me to take up very much space in the grow room this winter, so they're gonna have to suck it up and get it together in the next 2 weeks or bye-bye. And spoiler alert, probably gonna be more of a bye-bye situation. I have tons of heliconias. I already moved a whole bunch of them in. So it's like, do I need to save these two? Like, are we getting a little bit ridiculous here? Maybe. This might be too much.
Yeah, that fun time of year where you just say, I don't know what's going on. This is definitely a shorter vlog for as long as my vlogs normally. There's a lot going on. Everything's okay, just like busy scrambling, trying to get things done before it gets really, really cold out.
And we're already kind of there, actually.
Everybody's doing well, having a great day and a great life, and everything's just going beautifully for you.
There may or may not be a vlog next weekend. I don't know for sure, because like I said, I'm kind of struggling and scrambling here to keep up with everything, and I need to maintain my sanity for the sake of the plants.
We will see. Maybe something short. Maybe do a live stream. I don't know. Let's figure something out.
But if there isn't a video next weekend, no need to message me asking if everything's okay. If that's the case, it just means I got really busy. That's all it means. Everything's fine.
Can't wait to see the dogs come out here. They're gonna be so confused. They're gonna come running out that door and just...
No, they're probably... I bet they're gonna pee on these, aren't they?
Yeah, probably. That's what dogs do sometimes.
Hey, what's this? I have no idea. Let me pee on it.
It's one of the many reasons why we love our dogs, right?
Hey, Pumpkin. What are you doing? You're chasing something. You gonna pretend like you weren't now that I'm in here recording you? That sounds about right.
So nice to have the plants back in the house.
It's one thing I don't mind. I kind of like having them in here. And this time, they'll probably just be staying. They won't be staying like this on my counter. That was just like a quick in the door, set it down sort of thing. But with the ones that aren't getting in the way in the garage where I'm working right now trying to clean up, I don't see a reason to move them back out. I'll just leave them there.
The new leaf on that philodendron, I showed the little baby leaf as it was coming up last week. The one that was coming out the middle. There it is. It grew. It did what plants do. That's exciting.
All right, as always, and most importantly, everybody,
keep on growing.
Bye.